Dear students, welcome to the next lecture in our series of metals and non-metals in organic synthesis. We are looking at different metals and non-metals for how we can use them in carrying out our organic synthesis. Synthesis of different molecules, how we can carry out a part of a particular reaction using these metals and non-metals. In our previous lectures, we have seen about the use of mercury and boron. Now, in this lecture, we will continue it with the silicon in organic synthesis. Organic synthesis using silicon. Silicon is a peculiar compound which is very much similar to that of carbon, because carbon and silicon both are group 4 old nomenclature mein group 4 elements. So because of that they are having 4 valency. And their bond strengths are very much similar. They have a carbon silicon bond is a very strong bond with energy of 284 kilojoules per mole. Similarly, oxygen silicon, then fluorine silicon and chlorine silicon bonds are also formed. Amongst them, the fluorine silicon bond is the strongest one with 590 kilojoules per mole energy needed to break this. Oxygen silicon is also similarly very strong bond, and fluoro silicon bond is slightly weaker than oxygen and fluorine. That is, it requires 485 kilojoules per mole of energy. So compared to this oxygen, fluorine and chlorine, it forms a slightly weaker bond with carbon. Lekin carbon silicon bond is also quite stronger bond. So it is also a very strong bond that needs to be broken. So it requires a little larger energy, and the compounds that are formed are very stable. Because of this high strength of bonds, the compounds that are formed here, that is the organosilicon compounds that we call it as silanes. These silanes jo hote hain ye kafi stable compounds hote hain, jaldi se react nahi karte hain, lekin special conditions agar hum dete hain to yahan pe reactions hamare hote hain. Lekin yahan pe hyperconjugation effect hota hai kafi zyada, aur iski wajah se ye easily removable hota hai in presence of certain electrophiles and nucleophiles. So it facilitates the reactions under the conditions that we can utilize it for our purposes. Silicon has empty d orbitals which it can use to take up the electrons as well as donate the electrons. So that extra electrons can be taken up by the silicon in its empty d orbitals. Nucleophilic substitution reactions can be carried out by exchange of halides with the silicon, that is halogen silicon bond can be replaced by a silicon carbon bond, similar to what we have it for carbon. But the carbon substitution reactions are little slow, silicon substitution reactions are faster. So we can take up this, agar aapke molecule mein kahi halides hai aur dusri ek jagah pe aapko सिलिकॉन डालना है तो यू कैन इजीली डू इट, बिकॉज हैलोजन का एक्सचेंज विद कार्बन जो बॉन्ड है उसका स्लो होगा, बट सिलिकॉन विल बी एडेड लिटिल फास्टर. सिलिकॉन हैज एम्प्टी डी ऑर्बिटल्स व्हिच कैन रिसीव इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर्स, सो दैट कैन बी यूटिलाइज्ड टू वेरी गुड इफेक्ट फॉर ऑर्गेनिक सिंथेसिस. देन सिलिकॉन स्टेबिलाइजेस कार्बोनियन और द कार्बोकैटायन बाय हाइपर कॉन्जुगेशन. तो कार्बोकैटायन जो यहाँ पे होंगे पर्टिकुलरली ऑन द बीटा कार्बन, बीटा टू द सिलिकॉन, सिलिकॉन का ये अल्फा कार्बन एंड ये बीटा कार्बन है. सो बीटा कार्बन पे अगर कार्बोकैटायन होंगे तो सिलिकॉन उसे स्टेबिलाइज कर सकता है बाय यूजिंग हाइपर कॉन्जुगेशन, वेयर बाय इट विल डोनेट इट्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स to this carbon-carbon bond, and this will acquire a positive charge, will remain there itself in vicinity as it is a hyperconjugation. लेकिन इसमें अगर कोई न्यूक्लियोफाइल हम साथ में ऐड करते हैं तो वो न्यूक्लियोफाइल सिलिकॉन को अटैच करेगा एंड इट विल बी गेट आउट एंड वी विल गेट अ ओलेफिन. कार्बन दैट इज कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड्स कैन बी इजीली फॉर्मड यूजिंग दिस सिलेन्स इफ यू कैन हैव अ कार्बोकैटायन एट द बीटा पोजीशन. सिमिलरली अगर अल्फा पोजीशन पे कार्बेनियन होगा देन ऑल्सो इट विल बी स्टेबिलाइज्ड. Carbanion on the alpha position will also be stabilized because this will be the lone pair of electrons will be accommodated in the empty d orbitals of silicon, and so there will be momentarily or partial carbon silicon double bond will be generated and the carbanion will be stabilized over here. We'll take up the how these silanes are being formed. Synthesis of silanes. The tetrafluorosilicon, when reacted with alkyl zinc. Will be giving us tetraethyl silane and 2 moles of zinc chloride will be released. Similarly, SiCl4 when reacted with Grignard reagent, it will give us RSiCl3 plus MgCl2 or MgxCl, and this can be further reacted with 1 more mole of RMgCl or RMgX without R2SiCl2. R3SiCl, and finally we will get R4Si. But this particular compound is of more interest for us, the tetraalkyl silanes. Trialkyl silanes are of very much important for us because this will be utilized for many purposes in creating and carrying out the reactions. The third way of synthesis is by reacting SiCl4 with organolithium. 4 moles of organolithium compound will give us SiR4 and 4 molecules of lithium chloride. So this way we can form the alkyl silanes can be easily generated by reacting it with other organometallic compounds like zinc, maybe copper can be used, magnesium or lithium can be used. Generally, it is the lithium and magnesium which are utilized for this purposes. The Grignard reagent or the organolithiums are utilized because they are rapid reactions. So fast reaction will be carried out. We will see some reactions of this, like Peterson's. Olefin synthesis. It is an organosilicon that will be utilized. Like, for example, we can have CH3 MgCl or CH2. PhMgCl, that is benzyl magnesium chloride, when reacts with trimethyl silyl chloride, it will be giving us PhCl. CH2 SI CH3 price. This, when reacted with a base like N-butyl lithium, it will extract a proton from here. It will be giving us a carbanion. This carbanion, if it is reacted with a ketone or an aldehyde, this carbanion will attack the carbonyl group and we will get CH, CH, C, OH, R, R dash. Here we will have a SiMe. Now this will undergo elimination reaction. This will be undergoing the elimination reaction of OH and SiMe3, so that we will have a Me3 SiOH will be lost out. And we will get pH. Double bond R R dash. So an alkene can be easily obtained from here. We can obtain this particular organosilane by using three different methods. We can use it. These are organosilicons or organosilanes that are utilized for this. The formation of carbanion equivalent can be done by reacting or formation of carbanion equivalent. What we had done it, carbanion, that can be formed by using three different ways. One is by reacting with organolithium. If we have an alpha beta unsaturated silanes, then this R will be added if over here this carbon, and here we will have a negative charge. That negative charge will be stabilized with lithium. So carbanion will be generated by this way. Second method of generating a carbanion can be extraction of a proton from allyl silanes. If we have an allyl silane like this, we have this particular group is an allylic group. This is an allylic group we have. So that allylic group, if it is having a silicon attached to it, organosilicon, then it will be allyl silanes. This allyl silanes have this carbon. We have a allyl silane. यहाँ पे जो दो hydrogens हैं, ये दो hydrogens acidic होते हैं, because here the carbanion generated will be stabilized by silicon on MDD orbitals as well as this carbon double bond which is in conjugation with this. So it will be having more stabilization there. So it can be easily extracted by using organolithiums. So there, instead of addition of R over the carbon-carbon double bond, it will be extracting a proton. So R minus will be acting as a base here and not as a nucleophile. Will have a negative charge that is stabilized by lithium. Third method can be for organomagnesium, that is Grignard reagents. We have a halo silyl, then that can be reacted with magnesium to generate. Grignard reagent, which will be bearing carbon with a negative charge. The carbanions can be easily obtained from here. Now, whatever the hydroxysilane that we got it, beta hydroxysilane जो हमें यहाँ पे मिला था, यहाँ पर हमें ये जो beta hydroxysilane मिला है, it is having, this is alpha carbon to silane and this is beta carbon possessing a hydroxy group. So it is a beta hydroxy silane that we are getting it. So this beta hydroxy silane can lose the hydroxy group and the silicon by two different ways, so that we can generate either E alkene or the Z alkenes. Both can be prepared, either E alkenes or Z alkenes can be easily prepared by changing the conditions. Beta hydroxy silanes that are derived by reacting it with aldehydes or ketones can stereoselectively form either E or Z alkene depending on conditions. If we apply, is for E alkenes, if you want to generate, then we can apply basic conditions for this. Under basic conditions, we will get the E alkenes. What we had was this OH, R, R dash, and on the other side we had pH, H and SiH3. On the other side we have pH, H and silicon. Now under basic conditions what happens is this will be rotating so that silicon and hydroxy both are in the same side. So OH and SiMe3 will be on the same side, and if we do that, this will be going up, so pH will be coming here and H over here. OH up means R and R dash over here. Now when we apply basic conditions, say potassium hydride, it will be extracting proton from here from the hydroxy group. And it will result into syn elimination. Syn elimination resulting in formation of this particular. So if we have, say, here R dash is H, if we are taking R dash as H, then this will be p-alkene will be formed. Similarly, if you want to have a z-alkene with R dash equals to H, for z-alkene, we will be considering acidic conditions. And we can use acids like BF3 in ether, diethyl ether, BF3, we can use this. Over here, in the basic conditions, we can use either KH or NaH in PHF. We can use these reagents for carrying out E-alkene synthesis. Z-alkene ke liye we can use the acidic conditions like PF3, which is a Lewis acid. So what we'll have is, we'll have a OH with R, R dash, we are taking it as H. Here we have a SiMe3, H and pH. Now in this case, what happens is, BF3 is attacking this OH group because of BF or boron has an empty p orbital. So oxygen's lone pair will be attacking the empty p orbital of boron. So it has to approach from here. And when it approaches from here, this trimethyl silane will be extracting it because of its steric hindrance. Ye yahan pe move karega, it will be rotating this carbon-carbon bond. Call this as like this. H over here and pH over here. So now in this position, it will be forming a bond with BF3. And it will result into anti-elimination or E2 elimination. E2 elimination or anti-elimination, where R and pH will now be on the same side and two hydrogens will be on the other side. So it will result into formation of Z-alkene. So depending on condition, we can find out or we can synthesize the either E-alkene or Z-alkene, whichever we want it, we can easily carry out these reactions very easily over here. So ye hamara stereo selectivity ke liye kafi kaam mein aata hai. Peterson synthesis, olefination synthesis mein hum stereo selectivity very easily we can do it by choosing which base or either basic conditions or the acidic conditions, we can have either E or Z alkenes. Similarly, we can do inversion of configuration of alkene. If suppose we have E-alkene और हमें Z चाहिए है, लेकिन हमारे से E-alkene बन गया है, तो हमें वो E का Z हम बना सकते हैं by using this silanes, organo silanes से हम वो easily कर सकते हैं. Like for example, we have this particular E-alkene, we have it. We can react it with peroxy acid like metachloroperbenzoic acid, MCPBA. We can react it so that across this carbon-carbon double bond, there will be an epoxide formation will happen. epoxide formation will happen. And when we open this epoxide by using trimethyl silyl anion, this trimethyl silyl anion can be obtained by this particular, when we react it with this molecule with sodium methoxide, it will give us an adder of OME, and we will have a trimethyl silyl anion will be generated. This anion can be then used up for opening this epoxide. SiME3, and over here we will have HRO-. Now this can be rotated so that silicon and O minus comes on the same side because of higher affinity of silicon oxygen bond. It will be following the syn elimination. Syn elimination will happen. Here this reaction is a SN2 reaction, and here it will be SiME3 O minus. We have hydrogen and R. Here we have hydrogen and R dash. Yes, full 180 degree turn aega. So yeah, R dash will be coming on the right hand side bottom. So we will have the elimination or syn elimination of Me3SiO-, and will result into formation of Z alpha. We had started with E alkene and we got the Z alkene by first reacting the carbon-carbon double bond with an per acid to form an epoxide. This epoxide can be opened via SN2 nucleophilic substitution reaction, and then this will facilitate the syn elimination. To give us a Z alkene.